Thank you, Ivy. Good morning. How's everyone? So let's talk about the heart. Be careful, little heart, who you trust. You know, that song, it fits in perfectly with the gospel lesson today. And it fits in perfectly with the sermon that everyone looking at you is going to hear. And we pray that their heart is open to hear what God says about sin. So let's stay today, let's talk about the heart then. What is on Tuesday? Tuesday the 14th is? You have a Valentine's for your sweetheart, do you? Do you really? Very good. Mom and Dad know about that. Now they do. So, you know, whenever we talk about Valentine's Day, we always talk about hearts. Yeah, we always talk about hearts. And notice how many hearts are on here. Three hearts. Now, in the church, whenever we see three, we always think of the Trinity. We always think of God. But let's talk about hearts. How do we know that we love? We always think that when we see a heart like this, that means love. But how do we know how to love? Because Jesus first loved us. We cannot possibly know what it means to love unless we understand Jesus' love for us. So therefore, when we see a heart like this, and we think about love, we should immediately think about who? Jesus. Yeah, because the Bible tells us that God is love. So here's the question I have for you. What is love? What is love? Huh? Jesus is love, that's true. What did Jesus do to prove to you his love for all of us? Yeah, you're all ahead of me, aren't you? Yeah, but whenever I show you this picture, it should make sense to us, doesn't it? Because Jesus said, greater love hath no man than this, that he laid down his life for his friends. Greater love hath no man than this, than he laid down his life for his friends. And this is what this picture shows us. Jesus has such a great love for all of you, and great love for everyone looking at you, that Jesus did what? He died on the cross. He went to the cross. This is the definition of love. Now in the world we hear all kinds of definitions of love, but all those loves are based on man's ideas, on a man's thoughts. But the love that we talk about in the church is based upon what Jesus showed us. Jesus just didn't talk about love. Jesus did it. Jesus did it. He went to the cross for you. So on this Tuesday, you're going to be hearing a lot about love, you know, and some of you are going to be buying Valentines for your sweethearts. Isn't that right? Yeah, he's smiling. Still smiling. Good. But you know, when we speak about love, remember, we as Christians, our mind should immediately go to Jesus and the cross. For without Jesus and the cross, we would have no idea what love means. We would have no idea what it means that our friend has laid down his life for us. And we would not know what it means to serve one another. Because that's truly the definition of love. Jesus came to be a servant. Jesus came to serve and to save us. Jesus came to die on the cross for us. The definition of love. So, a happy Valentine's to all of you, or should I say, a happy God loving you day, God loving you every day. That's okay, David. It's okay that she's last. It's okay. Oh, that's not David. Let's fold our hands and bow our heads and let us pray. We pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for being the definition of love for us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for showing us what love truly is. For you were willing to die. You are the only man willing to die for us to take away our sin. And therefore, Jesus, it is true that your word says God is love, for you are love. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the great work that you have done for us. And we give you thanks, Lord Jesus, for showing us what it truly means to love. And all the children said,